Joining me is our medical correspondent and OBGYN herself, Dr. Jennifer Ashton, who's going to be with us as we go through this series. Good morning.
Good morning, Maggie.
So as you can see, we're all very excited to have our babies. You've delivered more than 1,000 babies. What's the most exciting part for you as an OB?
I'll tell you, Maggie, the thing that really stays with me time after time is that there are over 1,000 children walking around this planet, and my hands were the first hands on them as they came into the world. And you know, in medicine, there are so many times there's such tragedy, sadness, there's disease, death. To be in a field like OBGYN where there is so much happiness and you're helping to bring life in the world, there is nothing better.
I can imagine. And you're going to be helping us through this series answer some of the questions and bring us up to date on the technologies. Some of the questions you heard in the piece, like the food thing. What can you eat? What can you not eat?
Right.
What's your take on that?
Food is a big thing, and it always generates a lot of anxiety because, again, you get 10 pregnant women in a room, they'll hear 10 different things from their friends, their relatives, their obstetricians. I think the idea, obviously, is you want to eat a well-rounded, nutritious diet, which a lot of non-pregnant people don't do.
That's true.
When you're growing another human being, you want to really put a lot of effort. You want to give it a college try. But there are some things that we normally tell pregnant women, as I'm sure you've heard, you and I have talked about it, that you want to stay away from. And really, they come from the foods you want to avoid. Mm. So usually the first and biggest one is mercury. So fish that are like shark, tilefish, tuna, swordfish, those foods tend to be high in mercury, those fishes, and you want to try to minimize that to no more than about 6 ounces a week. The next thing is undercooked meat or eggs. So now is not the time to go for the steak tartare when you're out at a restaurant. You want to make sure things are well cooked. Unpasteurized dairy is a big risk because it carries a bacteria known as listeriosis. So you want to stay for the hard cheeses. You want to avoid excessive caffeine, so you can have one cup of coffee or tea a day.
Okay.
And obviously, alcohol is a no-no.
All right, Jen, thank you. So glad you'll be with us for this series.
Can't wait.
So glad you're here every day in case me and Erica decide to
Go into labor
right here.
You guys have your own OBGYN 24/7.
That's awesome. And she's very close.
I think she might be in early labor today.
Ooh, stay
just
tuned.
Just kidding.
Stay tuned. And next week on Early's Having a Baby, we're going to look at the fears that many expectant moms have during their pregnancy and how doctors these days address them. For example, we've come a long way with fetal testing. That's just one of the things that we'll show you next week.